Hello everyone! Want to get every cool free items? Go watch the whole video! Click like and subscribe in the next 3 seconds! Alright, let's go! Some of you are confused about this game, let me teach you how to get free limited UGC items from this game. First, click free UGC icon. These are the lists of items that you can get for free. Each item shows the number of copies and the cost of UGC coins. Earning UGC coins is very simple, but there's a limit of earning coins. The limit of earning coins is only 150 per day. There are several ways to earn coins. The first thing is by completing daily rewards. Every time you take a while from this game, you can claim your reward, and each reward contains UGC coins. Very simple, right? For the second way, it's by opening the chests. You will unlock rewards. Now you should equip the higher level and sell the lowest one. Keep continuing with this process because some of the chests contain UGC coins. If you haven't chests to open, then use the auto fight now. Every time you win, you can earn more rewards. Let's end the battles. As you can see, we got our rewards, which include chests. Now let's open more chests to get more UGC coins. Keep opening more chests until you get more UGC coins. You can see your progress here on how many UGC coins you earn. This is how they look. These items are actually very cool. They even have different colors which make you look cooler. Join this game called Shark Bite Classic. To get started, begin as a shark. I'm here with my alt account to make it easier. This also works in a public server for obtaining the item. Let's wait for the round to start. You need to be the shark. Once you're in, find and touch all 4 balls floating around the map. Just follow where I go to find them. You'll receive a super boost once you touch all 4 balls. Now follow me. Don't use the super boost yet. You will need to find a spot with green cracks underwater. I've seen the spot with green cracks. Let's go back and use the super boost to break the cracks. After destroying the cracked wall, wait until the memo talks end. Return to the lobby by waiting for the round to end. Once you're back in the lobby, follow where I go. Stand near this picture and click on the Say It button to drop the 4 balls. Now wait for another round to start. This time, you need to be a survivor. Take note of this place. Let's drive the boat and follow where I go. Dive underwater, and you'll see the Titanic submerged. Attach the 4 balls to the Titanic. If you run out of oxygen, float up and continue attaching the balls. After attaching the 4 balls, talk to Memo again to receive the gem. Do this quickly if you have enough time or wait for another round to start. Once you receive the gem, climb to the top of the lighthouse. Place the gem into the telescope. And point it directly at the sun or moon if it's night. A portal will appear when you point the telescope at the sun. Enter the portal to fight the boss shark. Now you need to defeat the boss shark. After each attack, he will shoot rockets at you. Make those rockets hit the boss shark to damage him. Just watch how I defeated him. Finally, we did it! Once you defeat the boss shark, the ocean will split in half. Quickly walk straight and touch the item before the split ocean closes. These are all the items we obtained. We also received blue clothes. This item is very cool and worth getting too. There's a cool free item you can get from this game. In this game, you will need 2 players and a private server. You can use your alt account to play this game on another device or ask a friend to help you. Here's me creating my private server, and don't worry, the private server is free. Next, go to Book 2. As you can see, I had my alt account join. Now let's play. Keep an eye on what I'm clicking. Click on Commands. Set the map. Click Chapter 1. Go to Set Mode. Click on Player. Set Piggy. and choose your friend or alt account. Finally, skip the timer. Now that we're finally here, what you need to do is unlock all the doors by finding all the missing keys. Sometimes the red key does appear here. Just keep in mind that even though you see me finding the missing key in this place, it doesn't mean you will also find it here. Remember, all the keys are in different hidden locations for everyone. I found the red key, now let's unlock the door over here. For me, this game is quite challenging, but once you know this map, it will be much easier for you to navigate. This map is small, making it easier to remember. I found the orange key. You can unlock the door right over here. I found a scissors, let's use them in this place. Finally, I found the blue key. Let's unlock the door over there. I found the green key. Let's unlock this door right over there. Lastly, I found the mop. Let's go back to the door where we unlocked it using the red key. Now we can proceed since we have finally unlocked all the doors with the red, blue, and green keys. Before we start, please ensure your volume is up so we can hear when someone knocks on the door. Click on the door and listen carefully. I heard two knocks. Let's make a note of that so we don't forget. Next, let's head to the cafe where the dice is located. Set the number on the dice to match the number of knocks we heard on the door. Now, go back. Click on the middle door again. I heard six knocks. However, in this clip, I misheard and wrote down five instead of six. So, I wasted a minute, but it doesn't really matter because you can knock on the door again, and once you put in the correct number, the third dice will appear, so you must keep an ear out for it. Now let's click the door again. I heard six knocks once more. Now, the third dice will appear next to this table since you set the second dice correctly. Set the dice to match the number of knocks we heard. Now, go back to the door. It has finally been unlocked. Let's go inside. Once inside, you must flick all of the levers facing the wall, and the gate will open. After that, go to every single torch and click on them until they blow out. Next, return to the levers and make them face the other side. In this final room is where you need to input your 3-digit code from the 3 dice. On the walls, there are buttons with lines based on the number of lines on them. I have made a diagram to help you find all the buttons. Now, all you have to do is input all the numbers in order. Once you've done that, the last gate should open. And there you have it, we have finally obtained the items. We also obtained these free clothes along with this purple crown. This is how they look, they are quite challenging to get but very worth it once you have it. Join this game where you can obtain various codes to unlock free items. Follow the path I go. I'll show you each code that will help you get many free items. Take a look at these cool purple items. We also receive additional items, which are pretty cool too. Join this game! I highly recommend joining in the private server. Now, go to the gift icon. Enter Unicorn. And click Redeem. We now have the VR goggles. Go back. Click on your character. Select glasses. Equip your VR goggles. Press F6 on your keyboard. The command should appear. Enter admin set mode cough as the first command. And then admin set map factory as the second. I highly recommend using a computer to make it easier. This command only works with a private server. To make the command disappear, press F6 again. Join the factory. Here, you need to scan the missing unicorn parts, which are easy to find. Just take a note of this place. After scanning all parts, go over to the blue door. Now you will do a puzzle with the unicorn pieces. Click the head, then the wings, front legs, and tail. Once you've done it correctly, you should get teleported to this map. Follow every V and shoot all the zombies. The easiest way to kill all zombies is to crawl. Press X on the keyboard so you can't get hurt by the zombies. As you can see, they can't even see you. This is the easiest way so you can kill them immediately. Now let's shoot their hot dogs and eggs since they can't see us. Every time you clear the zombies, the V appears. Follow it. Shooting zombies is absolutely fun. I enjoy this game, not gonna lie. Now let's shoot their balls. After completing all zombie waves, walk straight into the white area to claim the free item. Now let's collect the item. This is how they look. We even get free clothes. These items are easy to obtain and look great. Join this game. Straightforward to this ship. Now wait for the progress to end. To get the item in this game, you just have to win in the freeze tag mini game. You will either be a seeker or a runner. If you are a runner, you must stay away from the taggers, don't get caught, and avoid getting frozen. As a seeker, you must freeze all the players to win and get the free item. Our goal here is to win. If you win, you will immediately receive an item. Luckily, I won, so I got the item. This is how it looks. It absolutely looks cool. For the next game, we will obtain a free item from Vehicle Simulator. Click on the first one. Next, we need to get a car to travel around. Go to Vehicles and press drive to start driving the car. After that, click on the map and head to this place I'm pointing to. It's a laboratory. Let's drive there together. Just follow where I drive and take note of this place so you will know where the laboratory is located. Press F to leave the car. Once we're at the laboratory, go inside. Now buy food from the machine in the correct order. Make sure to enter them in order. A secret elevator will appear once you do this. Then interact with the AR goggles on the ground and purchase them for $0. Now you will need to find and collect all 8 hidden data drives. Reset your character to start collecting the missing data drives. Now enable your AR goggles by clicking your phone. Go to settings, select Bluetooth, and turn it on to see all 8 hidden data drives. The data drives are scattered around the map. Follow the map I provided to locate them easily. I created a map marking where the hidden data drives are located. Keep an eye out for these spots, as they show where all the missing data drives are. After finding all 8, the laser door should open. After that, reset your character again. Now, the last thing we need to do is rent the monster truck. Once we have rented the monster truck, we can use it to get inside the ship later on. I highly recommend renting it after finding all 8 data drives. I will not use this monster truck since it's hard to drive, so I will use my favorite car instead. Follow me back to the laboratory. You will want to use the code as before in order. Now that we have all 8 data drives, we can enter this part of the base. Go down. Spawn a car and drive straight. Then enter the code 1985. The ship has finally opened. Now, we need to find a way to get inside the ship. As I mentioned earlier, you really need this monster truck. Let's spawn the monster truck so we can proceed inside. Now that we're finally inside the ship, sit on the chair. Then boom, you'll instantly get the badge. This radio is definitely worth getting, even it's quite hard to get. Search up for this game. Unfortunately, you can no longer play this game. If you try to join, you will be kicked out. However, you can still get the item by joining the game even if you don't win the badge. This is my proof that I obtained the item simply by joining the game using my alt account. Look up for this game. When you join, go straight ahead until you see the parkour. It's right here. Now click on Quick Start. Your objective is to complete this hobby 3 times in under 1 minute and 25 seconds. If it takes you longer than that, try exiting the game and playing again. This hobby is quite challenging, and it took me about 10 tries to complete. Remember, you need to finish the hobby 3 times and complete it in 1 minute and 25 seconds or less each time to earn the badge. If it takes longer, you will need to start over again. If you see this badge, that means you get them. This is how it looks. Join this game called the 8th Annual Bloxy Awards. When you join, you will appear in this place. Now, wait until the loading progress ends. Just watch the show, which won't take a while, so grab some food while waiting. Once it's all over, go to the shop. And press collect your outfit to get them. Look how cool it is, a blue and purple set. We also get this as an extra. This game is only for computers and won't work on mobile devices. To obtain the 5 free items in this game, you'll need a total of 500 Roblox to purchase them from the UGC shop. You can earn Roblox by completing quests, with each item costing 100 Roblox. Let's begin by completing quests, where each one gives 100 points. The first quest is to read all the books in the library. Click on the map to teleport to the library. Once there, interact with all the books to earn 100 points. Press E to interact. For the second quest, return to the lobby and speak to Karen. Follow the locations I select to find Karen's for missing toys. The first is at the library. The second at the podcast lounge. The third at the Boba Cafe. And the last upstairs. After finding them, return to Karen to claim your 100 points, totaling 200. For the third quest, talk to Karen again. Now you will need to interact with two founders. The first founder is Eric. Then visit the next founder, which is David, to earn an additional 100 points, totaling 300. For the fourth quest, speak to David again. Now you will need to find all the different avatar types as I guide you. After that, return to David to claim your points, bringing the total to 400. For the final quest, go to the Boba Cafe. And interact with Harrison. Select Need Any Help? Return to the lobby and give the boba to Karen. Then go back to Harrison to receive your points, reaching a total of 500. After that, head to the map and teleport to the UGC shop to claim all the free UGC items. Interact with Julie and claim your rewards. This is how they look in your avatar. The black and white accessories look super cool and are worth getting. We also have these two cool accessories, which are similar to the first one. And lastly, this flag item looks great. This game called Beat the Scammers. Let's join! To obtain the item in this game, you need to interact with these NPCs or signs and provide them with the correct answer to receive the item. You need to do this for 10 of them. I will show you where they are. Don't worry, all the answers are unreliable. However, I recommend understanding the questions to avoid being scammed. This is how the item looks.